Fortnite family, Buncha Crunch Army, it's your one and only Keith Allen, your motivation guy, back again. So excited and pumped up to bring you guys the latest and greatest tips and tricks to make you the best Fortnite player you can possibly be. You know, it's almost been a full week now since the island got cubed, and just recently Arena Mode has finally opened its doors for the new season. So, with that being said, how is the meta going to be developed from here on out? Well, we have a few ideas, and they involve the sideways weapons. So, with each new season, we've seen the addition of theme weaponry, and it isn't always welcome right off the bat. You know, we can all remember when primal weapons were absolutely hated when they first made their way into the meta. Even IO weapons were just, like the scanner, were just shunned by the community for how easily it could just detect enemy players through walls. Yet today, with the addition of sideways weapons, the community has remained balanced in the amount of praise and dislike it's received. However, all it takes to tip the community into embracing the new weaponry is a few pros using them to demolish the competition. All right, so just look how Mitro's use of the minigun back in the day made it a much more viable option once the community saw what it could do. Although it's too early to tell the extent of their impact on the competitive meta, we are already getting glimpses of them making an impact on some of our favorite Fortnite pros. Players such as Mongrel, Benji Fishy, and Mr. Savage are some of the players who have already begun to see the power and potential of the sideways weapons this season. You know, sometimes that's all it really takes to get an item to just really snowball into something much greater. Alright, so there are two sideways weapons currently in the loot pool. That is the sideways rifle and the sideways railgun. There is also talk of a sideways shotgun, which will supposedly be added in a future update. But for now, we're going to focus on the rifle and the railgun. Alright, so both offer a unique playstyle that makes them useful in different situations, with the current favorite being the sideways minigun. Let me ask you this. Do you feel like you could be playing better in Fortnite? Well, the truth is, you're probably right. You know, everyone has the potential to play better, including you. You just might need a little push in the right direction, which you could get from our team of world-class pro coaches. They're going to play with you, man, in your games, you know, guiding you past all your mistakes so you can unlock your hidden Fortnite potential. All you need to do is click the link in the description to reach ProGuides.com. Sideways pockets and anomalies. If the sideways weapons are going to become heavily evolved in the meta, then the first thing to take into consideration is how to obtain them. You know, there are two main locations where these weapons are available, and both involve a little RNG. That's through sideways pockets and sideways anomalies. You know, the pockets usually cover up a large portion of the main POI, similar to, you know, how the UFO would be covering an entire area during each match. You can spot them easily as the big orange circle when you pull out your map. Anomalies are like smaller versions of the sideways pockets that are represented as shining purple spots on the map. Usually, they will spawn in three separate locations, but more on that later as we discuss the best ways to get your sideways loadout ready in the early game and including them later on as the match progresses. All right, so the minigun is always a welcome addition to the Fortnite meta. You know, this time around, we got the minigun back with a twist. The new sideways minigun is a weapon that can be upgraded with monster parts. This weapon benefits from getting more powerful and more precise the closer it comes to overheating. With the weapon's quick fire rate, the extra power absolutely shreds through builds and shields better than the original. Just looking at CypherPK's stream from a few days ago showcases just how easily it could do just that. This can make the weapon very useful for tearing down builds in the late game and a viable option to consider when deciding loadouts for your squad. You never know when you're gonna need to level the playing field or have suppressing fire. So the sideways rifle is a hitscan weapon. First shots always have more accuracy and can be continuously shot for the overheat bonus. Seeing as mythics are always less common, you know, it's interesting to see them just be made more available through crafting. The mythic sideways rifle in particular rewards players with a whopping 57 body shot after 4 continuous shots. Even at lower rarities, the sideways rifle is still a very capable weapon. You know, the green variant has a 65 headshot damage after 4 shots, and the legendary variant has a pretty solid 50 headshot damage prior to overheating and a 50 body shot after your first 4 shots. So seeing how powerful these weapons can be, our next question is, are, what do I need to upgrade them and how much? So how much does each upgrade really cost? You know, we've taken the time to break it down for you to just start with the most common drop being the green rarity. 15 to upgrade to blue, 20 for purple, 25 for gold, 50 for mythic. Monsters will drop either 3 or 5 parts depending on how powerful an enemy is. You're gonna be able to tell the difference depending on the size of the monsters. Some are the same size as you, while others are clearly much larger and deadlier. They will also commonly drop ammunition and fill up your shield bars, so don't be afraid to use your ammo when taking them down. So one good strategy on how to get the most out of your cubes is to skip the 15 cubes required to upgrade a green weapon to blue, and instead focus on fighting a blue weapon and upgrading it to a purple. Blue weapons are actually not that hard to pull from a sideways chest, and saving your cubes for the better weapon guarantees that you're gonna need to spend less time grinding enemies and more time getting yourself to the next fight. So considering how important it's gonna be to rack up elimination points, you might wanna drop in your main POI first. One strategy we recommend is to hold off on entering the main sideways bubbles and instead aim for these purple points on the map when you get the chance. All right, so what exactly are they? Well, these are the tiner anomalies that we mentioned earlier that expand into a smaller version of what you see on the main POIs. These will usually be scattered at random points in the map, so you can just plan to include them in your loot routes whenever they become available. Okay, so the good thing about these tinier pockets is that they are less contested compared to the main anomaly bubbles. Another perk is that while the main bubble stays in the same position and can be caught in the storm, the smaller ones can spawn further inland, meaning you're gonna have the chance to enter later in the match. As the match progresses and the player count dwindles, these sideways anomalies can be easy pickings, so if you would prefer to focus on your main POIs first, then do so as the storm closes in. Take advantage of your more powerful loadout to get more monster cubes. Each sideways anomaly is guaranteed to have at least one chest upon activation. More importantly, these anomalies usually occur in very flat areas, and while rocks are generated to give the field a few more obstacles, it's usually much easier to avoid enemies and avoid them without, you know, hitting the side of a building. So go for it and just start taking down enemies. And so while your first instincts may be, you know, to beat the boss before the timer runs, consider your position. Are you entering in the early game or later on when you and your squad have better weapons? If you're going in early, your main targets should be the smaller monsters that continuously spawn. You know, they don't take that long to take defeat and are more consistent source for just monster cubes. Just one trip into these smaller pockets can land you with an epic weapon right off the bat. All right, so just keep in mind that there is a time limit, and once that's up, man, the enemies in any unopened chest will vanish. This is where another benefit of going for these smaller pockets really comes up, because the sideways disappears at the end of the time limit, and it also makes all the monsters vanish as well. Now you are free to really pick up any ammo and monster parts that were dropped without getting smacked by enemies from all sides. This is an excellent way of gathering pistol rounds, which are going to be extremely important if you plan to keep the sideways minigun in your inventory throughout the match. Once the sideways anomaly raid is done, a new one will become available not too far from the one you just completed. And so if you still want to try to get your weapon to legendary or even mythic, then this is the perfect opportunity to do so. However, keep in mind, guys, that an epic should be able to carry you until you can get more monster parts off the players you eliminate. So one amazing strategy that we've noticed going around is the reboot van trick. So if the anomaly covers an area where a reboot van is present, then you're going to want to get on top of the van. Why? Well, it's going to make the monsters stop dead in their tracks. The only thing that you're going to need to worry about is the few monsters that have a ranged attack, but you know, those don't always spawn. From there on, you can farm monster cubes throughout the entire duration of the raid without worrying about getting yourself killed. As of yet, Epic has yet to pass this, but for now, this is a viable option for farming monster parts. As we mentioned earlier, the sideways anomalies generate randomly before the match starts. What makes them different from the bubbles is the fact that the most of the time, like, you know, when they generate, they're gonna do so in unpopulated areas with minimum buildings or obstacles. However, one interesting place that can spawn is the middle of the crash sites. This is actually beneficial if you wanna take advantage of the loot in those POIs. You know, what many pros are noticing right now is that the crash sites are becoming one of the most viable places to land. Not only do they have the most chests than any of the main POI at the moment, but they have wind tunnels and launch pads that allow them to grab what they need and get out quickly. In this instance, you have more opportunities to grab a better loadout before going into an anomaly. You will also be able to just keep track of the other players as they activate it and third-party them while they're dealing with the monsters. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it for today's video. Hope you guys found it helpful. You know, with the competitive scene waking up from its very brief hibernation, we're definitely going to be seeing the meta shake up. So be sure to keep up with our videos so you can get the edge on your opponents. Once again, this is your motivation guide, Keith Allen. If you guys liked the video, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel. We have some amazing content coming up. We'll see you in the next one. Peace.